I think I'm gonna paint the 5 red. That's what everybody did back in the day, was red. So I'm gonna use the board as my means of antiquing the brush. I'm not gonna fill in, I'm just gonna make it to where it looks like it's been on there for a while, a few years, maybe 100. The way the board just creates a natural effect. I've got my color here for this this ribbon, and I'm eventually going to fill it in, I think, a little bit more than the 5, because it's forward of the 5. Thank you. Okay, so we are going to fill in peach color, this peach color today. It's it's going to take a little bit of this soft wood. It's going to make it representable. Okay, so now I've got the five obviously in the ribbon the kind of the way I want it, and I want this five to stand out just a little bit more. So I'm going to create a three-dimensional shadowing effect, and I'm going to pretend like the sun's coming from up here, the casting onto the three-dimensional five, which it isn't a three-dimensional five, obviously, but just cast some highlights here. So I'm going to do another highlight now. It's in a maroon color. So this would be the shaded side if the sun's coming from this direction. So. so. Okay, so I'm going to make a darker highlight, so it looks a little three-dimensional. I'm just going to go with a straight black here. Okay, so now I'm going to do the lettering in here, Cup of Joe, and I'm just going to kind of freeform it in there. So, using a kind of a fetch. It's mixing with the paint behind it, but it should be fine.
Just about that way. Maybe it was the hottest part of the day. saw one of them calling. Then you